Jordan fan at
all. Wow, why not?
I am not. I was always a Shaq and Kobe fan, never a Jordan fan.
Wow, yeah, yeah. Well, I was a Jordan fan. I ain't going to lie to y'all.
I was a Jordan fan,
too.
I'm not
going to play with y'all.
No, I was a Jordan fan, too, but you made LeBron.
Yeah, we on Boss Talk 101.
Man. Ooh, we going back to Akron, Ohio, Spring Hill, West Side, Akron, Ohio, Spring Hill Projects, right by LeBron James, same street.
Really?
Yep, East Avenue, same
wow.
street.
That's dope.
That's cool.
That's dope, mm-hmm. dope.
Did you know the family?
I mean, I ain't going to say, we wasn't like best friends, but you know, I definitely saw him. You know, I've been to his house before, not house, but when they stayed in the projects.
Okay.
Yeah, I've been over there before, always just... was just a different dude, you mm-hmm. know? You already knew.
Yeah, it
wasn't like, oh my God, like you knew. This dude is the only 18-year-old in the world. You can give $200 million to it, it ain't gonna change him.
Wow.
Special.
Wow.
Special.
And that's rare.
Yeah.
That is very rare.
He did that elementary school, that impressed me. Mm-hmm. You know, like when you start dealing with the kids and trying to find ways to, you know, do something that's that impactful, mm-hmm. when you start dealing with trying to make sure that you place yourself in the midst of it, that's where it's at. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Yeah.
Like everybody don't do that. Most people trying to find out something to try to push themselves up high, not to try to, you
Jordan,
know.
Jordan.
You knew I was going at it.
Jordan. I am not a Jordan fan at all.
Wow, why not?
I am not. I was always a Shaq and Kobe fan, never a Jordan fan.
Wow, yeah, yeah. Well, I was a Jordan fan. I ain't going to lie to y'all.
I was a Jordan fan, too.
I'm not going to play with y'all.
No, I was a Jordan fan, too, but, you man, LeBron, you know.
I like the underdogs.
I remember, okay, I went to a game with him, with his mom and my boy Dre back in the day. Shout out to Dre Gutt and Glow. Went to the game with them. I think he was a senior.
Okay.
And it was like, you know, everybody was there. They had the reps sitting with her, Nike, Jordan, and all them.
How old was he then?
He was 17.
Okay, cool.
High school senior. And I'm like, man, this dude watching him. I'm like, oh, my God. Like, this dude is, you know. After the game, we went back to a spot. Me, Dre, and Glow. LeBron went to eat with the reps, you know. So he came to the house. This is why I will fight somebody in the bar about LeBron James. He came to the house. He came in here like a star. Now, mind you, they poor.
Yeah, yeah.
Mm-hmm. He on all these magazines. They live in Spring Hill Projects, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
He come home and he has a styrofoam that has shrimp and stuff, you know, all the stuff he got from the fixings from the restaurant. He sat it down in front of his mom. He opened it up. It was full. It hadn't been touched. He went into the cabinet. He put out some oatmeal, instant oatmeal, put some water in it, heated up. He ate that.
Wow.
And I was like... She said he always do that. Whenever they give him something, he just bring it to me and he just eat what we got.
Oh,
that boy knows to stay humble, man.
So from that point, so that's why I get personal.
Nah,
on Facebook.
You should.
I'd be like, y'all, hey, meet me at Wild House.
Nobody ain't meeting
LeBron.
You, Mike. Mike, nobody's meeting you, bro. I didn't know you were this big, man. No, nobody meeting you, man. You don't have to worry about that.
I'm a teddy bear, man.
Whatever.
So have you always been this big growing up?
I was always taller, and I was big. I was fighting boys way older than me growing up. My mom, it's funny, she apologized to me. She was like, baby, I'm so sorry. You know, she was had me fighting these boys that she had no idea. It was like 6 or 7 years older than me because I was the same size as them.
Yeah.
But it helped me because, you know, people
she
my age.
She had you fighting them.
Oh, my mom was a gangster.
Mom ain't playing no games.
That sounds like that movie I saw where the mama took him back out there and be like, no, you going to fight. Come on, we going to fight.
That's her. She locked the door. Go out there and handle that.
She ain't trying to hear it.
Did you ever? And if you ever lost a fight, what would she do?
Oh, I lost. I was losing all of them because they was so much stronger than me. We just was the same size. Yeah. It was older, you know. But she would sit there. She told me. She said, baby, because I was like, man, mine was cold. But she said, you know, I used to watch you get out there and just get your butt whipped. And she said, I would just turn my face and cry and leave you out there because I knew, you know, you were a black man, so you had to
deal with. You had to endure.
Mm-hmm.
So where was Daddy during all this time?
He was in my life, but he had moved to Ohio. They got divorced, separated. He moved to Ohio. So she knew because she was a single mother.
And how old were you when they got divorced?
I was 10.
10? Mm-hmm. How did it affect you when he left?
Uh, I think it affect. I think divorce. Now that I look back on it as an adult, I think it does affect mm-hmm. how we view relationships, how we deal in relationships. But he was there. You know, I can't sit here and say my father was definitely there. You know, he just had to go out there and get his, you know, get himself together and get a job and everything. Because he was, we was doing bad, man. You know, it was rough. So,
but it made you into the person that you are today.
Exactly.
Yep. So you wouldn't trade it for nothing in the world.
I wouldn't trade it for nothing in the world. I ain't listen. My mama was a gangster, but she taught me. You know, it was a balance. She was rare because you know she would teach love and integrity, but she just was like, you ain't finna be no punk. So,
you had brothers and sisters.
A little sister.
So you the only boy.
I'm the boy. So it was me, two boy cousins, and like 20 girls. So we was always fighting. Like when I would go to Ohio. My Uncle Gerald, shout out to Uncle Gerald, he probably going to laugh when he see this, but he would have a list. Because I lived in Buffalo, so when I would go to Ohio, he peep me up from the Greyhound bus station and say, all right, this boy did this to your cousin. He had a list. Mm. And I had to go fight these boys.
It's a wonder you didn't end up being a boxer or something else.
I fought. I did mixed martial arts.
You did?
Mm-hmm.
How old were you when you got into that?
That was 2003. I was a Escambia County DT champion in Escambia County.
Lose any more fights after that?
Oh, I lost. When you win, you lose. See, people don't know about them mixed martial arts fighting. You know, you win, but you still lose.
Yeah. How?
You get beat up.
Yeah, because of the injuries.
Yeah, when you block a punch, see people, when you watch it on TV and somebody block a punch or a kick, you're like, oh, he blocked it. But this still hurt.
Yeah, it hurt you.
And
hurt
she you. Is, you know.
Let's go in a tub of ice after you get done.
Man, listen.
So you, when you was young like that and coming up, you said the projects? So how are the projects up there? Was it like every other project when you hear Calio or when you hear about the projects here in Dallas, mm-hmm. you know, whether it be over there at Bonton 007 mm-hmm. in the South or when you hear about stuff like when you
was
go to Atlanta? Yeah, like or in Vegas when we lived in Doolittle when I lived in Vegas. Uh-huh. So how is it like far as the projects where you were from?
In New York, it was, you know, the buildings were high, so it was more condensed. I think that's where the violence was so different, because it was like you really couldn't get away from people. You know, it's like y'all in the building, y'all live up on top of each other, so you got these small stairwells and elevators and, you know.
Pretty bad.
The building I live in now, we got concierge. Ain't no fight going on there, but you know, ain't no security. It's just, you know, you had to deal with your problems. I think it made me who I am today, because you had to, it wasn't no running from it. You had to deal with it. You got a bully, you know, you gonna see him every day in the elevator. So you're gonna have to throw some salt in his eye and get him out the way.
You got to work.
You got to fight dirty.
Yeah, we on Boss Talk 101.